Forever can never be long enough for me. I feel like I've had long enough with you. Forget the world now, we won't let them see. But there's one thing left to do. Now that the weight has lifted, love has surely shifted my way. Marry me today and every day. Marry me. If I ever get the nerve to say hello in this cafe, say you will. Say you will. Together can never be close enough for me to feel like I am close enough to you. You wear white and I wear out the words I love you, and you're beautiful. Now that the wait is over, love has finally showed her my.
Watching the night sky, or a beautiful sunrise. Well, there's so much they hold. And just like them old stars, I see that you've come so far to be right where you are. How old is your soul? Well, I won't give up on us, even if the skies get rough. I'm giving you all my love. I'm still looking up. And when you're needing your space to do some navigating, I'll be here patiently waiting to see what you find. See then the stars.
You may be seated. The first thing in all of creation that God said wasn't good was loneliness. Looked at man, who he had created in his own image, and said it's not good for man to be alone. So he put him into a deep sleep, and from the side he took a rib and he created Eve. Now, she wasn't taken from his head so that she might rule over him. She wasn't taken from his foot that he might trample over her. She was taken from his side she might be protected. His heart that she might be loved. This is the kind of commitment to companionship that you two come to enter into today. And so at this time, I just want to begin by asking, who is it that gives us the only way in holy matrimony? So before we get started, I thought we might share a little story about Travis and Jamie, these two lovebirds that we see before us. You know, love comes natural for some people, and others need to be prodded just a little bit. Travis, you're one of those. Travis has been praying, and we've been talking, and he said, you know, I know that God's got this woman out there for me, but I just don't know who she is. And then there was this beautiful, young, funny girl that worked at the church and was there all the time. And we kept going, Travis, what about her? And he kept going, no, she works here. That'd be odd. That'd be weird. And Travis, how about her? And before long, I think he worked up the courage and he walked her out one day, I remember, after work. Yeah, went out to clean out his car, even though he didn't have to clean out his car. He usually has to clean out his car, but he didn't on this day. And he went out just so that as Jamie walked to her vehicle, he could stop and talk to her, and he could ask her out for the very first time. And who would have thought that one awkward conversation, we would be here today, and that's exactly where we are. And so we've got a few things to discuss, and we want to talk about, guys, a lot of people get married today. You can go down to the courthouse, you can see a justice of the peace. I want you to know that's not the kind of wedding we're here for today. This is a Christian celebration. First and foremost, these two love Jesus with all their hearts. They're committed to Him. And so this is a Christian wedding ceremony. It may sound a little different from some you've heard, but we're going to talk about what the Bible would say for each of you first. And it's a sacred relationship because God ordained it. Right? The very first time, He presented Eve to Adam, and Adam looked and said, whoa, man, she is beautiful. That moment, he said, for this reason, the man will leave his mother and father and be united to his wife, and the two will become one flesh. So God was the first best man there in the garden, performed the very first wedding ceremony, much like what we're doing here today. So we walk in these great footsteps of the saints as we enter into this. Now, this isn't to be taken lightly. The Bible has some rules. It says, Travis, you to love your wife, Christ loved the church and gave up his life for her. It's a sacrificial love. It says, listen, I'm not going to put myself first, and it's not going to be my way, and you don't just get two drawers in the closet. I heard. But my dear, for the rest of our lives, I'll take just two drawers. And you can have everything I possess. Jane, may it be tougher for you. The Bible doesn't call the wife to love her husband, though she should. It says that she is to honor him, to serve him, she's to be obedient to him. That's scary for some ladies because they think guys are just in a real power, but I want you to look at this man before you. His promise to you today is never that he'll wield power over you, never that he'll take advantage of you, but rather that when you have to make that decision as the head of the household, he'll do so with each other, not at you. That he'll do so always having your best interest and the interest of God in you. That's what we're here for. And the Bible says that the grass withers and the flowers fade, but the word of the Lord endures forever. And so we thought it'd be appropriate at this time to just read the word of the Lord a little bit. And so we've got a couple that we're going to share if they don't mind.
Ecclesiastes 4:9-12. Two is better than one because they have a good return for their labor. If either of them falls down, one can help the other up. Also, if two lie down together, they will keep warm. But how can one keep warm alone? The line may be overpowered, two can defend themselves. A cord of three strands is not quickly broken.
In 1 Corinthians chapter 13, 7 verse 4, says, love is patient, love is kind, does not envy, does not boast, it is not proud, it does not dishonor others, it is not self-seeking, it is not easily angered, it keeps no record of wrongs, love does not delight in evil, it rejoices with the truth, it always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails. For where there are prophecies, they will cease. Where there are tongues, they will be stilled. Where there is knowledge, it will pass away. But we know in part, and we prophesy in part. But when completeness comes, what is in part disappears. When I was a child, I talked like a child, I thought like a child, I reasoned like a child. When I became a man, I put the ways of childhood behind me. For now we see only a reflection as in a mirror. Then we shall see face to face. Now I know in part, and I shall know fully, even as I am fully known. And now these three remain, faith, hope, and love, but the greatest of these is love.
Yeah. We're here today because you two said that you wanted to get married. You said that you wanted, yeah, Travis is going, what was I thinking? You know exactly what you're thinking at this time. And you two said you want to enter into this thing called holy matrimony, and so I'm about to ask you guys to take a vow. This is a big deal, because it's not just a vow that we make in the presence of our family. It's not just that they'll hold us accountable, though they better. But it's a vow that we make to God himself. Because the Bible says, when two or more are gathered, he's also here. And so the promise that you're about to make is meant to be an enduring promise, a promise that lasts a lifetime. All right? Are you guys ready to make that kind of commitment? Okay. And Travis, I start with you. If you just look into her eyes, I'm going to ask you some questions. And you just wait and respond. No trick questions. Do you, Travis, take Jamie to be your lawfully wedded wife? Do you promise to love her, to comfort her, to honor her, and to keep her? To stand by her in sickness and in health, as long as you both follow her. Jane, you need to take Travis to be your lawfully wedded husband. Do you promise to love him, to comfort him, to honor him and keep him, to stand by him in sickness and in health, for as long as you both follow him? Yeah, that's happening. I believe that each of you has a ring to give as a symbol. The wedding ring is an important symbol for a couple of reasons. One, it's a complete circle. It's unending. Your love for one another is meant to be that way. You can try to think about the day it began, but you can never really pin it down. Hopefully there'll never be a day that begins. So it reminds us, every time you play with it, every time you take it off, you just want to put it back on. So it's a symbol of your love for one another. It's also a symbol because it's made of some of the best metal we have here on earth. It's some of the best stuff there is. That's what God thinks about marriage. Some of the best stuff there is. It shouldn't tarnish. Faith, your love for one another shouldn't tarnish or fade. Travis, I'm going to ask you to do something for me. I want you to take that ring, and you're going to place it on her ring finger. That's the third finger on her left hand. Don't put it there yet, but you're going to repeat after me. You ready? Repeat after me, please. With this ring. Don't look at me. We're not getting married. It would be strange. Look at her. Let's try again. With this ring, I be wed. I give freely to you. All of my life. All of my love. All of my commitment. J, Jamie, I'm going to ask you to do the same on Travis's left hand, third finger there. Yeah. You got to give her the finger. I mean, like hold it out there for her. Not that one. It's a little hard with a hand like this. Jamie, I want you to repeat after me. I want you to look at him, not me.
Yes.
With this ring,
with this ring,
I be wed,
and
give freely to you,
all of my life,
all of my love,
all of my life,
and all of my feelings. Well, guys, by the power vested in me, as a minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ, in the state of Texas, my privilege to pronounce you husband and wife.
Hey.
You should rock. Woo!
Yeah. Oh, that's it.
Amateur hour.
I thought you loved her.
If you could hear what these guys are saying, that comes later, later after the reception. Children, cover your ears. As we said when we began this, this is a little different. This isn't, we're not at the county courthouse. This isn't justice of the peace. This is Christian marriage. And so as such, these two wanted to do something very special together this evening. And so they're going to take communion together. And just as a symbol. And here's the deal. As believers in Jesus, we only have two ordinances that we hold to. And the first is believer's baptism. It's a symbol. Christ died on the cross, he was buried, and he rose again. And every time somebody's baptized, we paint a picture for people of our faith in Christ. He died on the cross, was buried, and rose again. The same way, communion is a symbol. Christ's body had to be broken. His blood had to be shed. The Bible says without the remission, without the shedding of blood, there's no remission of sins. And so this is important. It also says that every time we take the Lord's Supper, we proclaim Jesus' death until he returns. And so that's what we're going to do this evening. If you guys would put up with us just for a moment here. On the night that Jesus was betrayed, the Bible says that he took bread and that he broke it. He said, "This is my body, broken for you. Every time you do this in remembrance of me." Take me. That same evening, they shared a glass of wine. I just wanted to warn you that this is not grape juice.
Chug it, Travis. Oh, wait, hold on, it's Travis.
And again, Jesus said, "This is the cup of the new covenant in my blood. Whenever you do this, drink this cup in remembrance of me. Please take and drink." Would you pray with me? Father, I thank you so much for Travis, for Jamie, and for this new life that we've all been able to bear witness to. I pray many, many, many blessings upon this couple. Use the people here. Remind them that they're not just guests away, but they are witness to an event that we pray will change the course of history of these families, of their children. God, I pray that you would use us to hold them accountable, to stick with it in the good times and the bad, to honor you with everything that they are and everything that they do. Lord, we celebrate the great gift of marriage today, and we celebrate these two becoming one. Lord Jesus, we give you thanks and praise. It's in your name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Well, family and friends, it is my honor to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Travis Early.